And now it's time for all of us to invite our Honorable Minister for Law, Parliamentary Affairs and Higher Education Government of Karnataka, Shri T.B. Jayachandra, for inaugural address. A round of applause for Honorable Minister, please.
Good morning to all. Today, there is a program of ours is that Jnana Sangama. That's a national convention on higher education. And we are having the 2 days conference focusing on the best practices in the higher education. And the chief guest is my close friend and is a Honorable Deputy Chief Minister and in charge of the higher education government of Telangana. He is here to deliver his speech, and the Bharat Lal Meena, the additional chief secretary, higher education, S.V. Ranganath, vice chairman of the higher education council, and Corey Gupta, and all the distinguished persons, vice chancellors who have come from other states. I think more than 5-6 states participation is there, and I welcome you all to the Bangalore once again and to this conference. It is indeed a pleasure to be here today amidst the August gathering of higher education stakeholders who are present here at Jnana Sangama conference, which is scheduled today and tomorrow at Bangalore. The objective of this conference is to promote the Karnataka model, that ICT, that is information communication technology, best practices in higher education among the leaders of higher education, and uphold the Karnataka as a leading destination of higher education in the country. The conference is an ideal platform for the education leaders to interact on best practices. Other important topics in higher education and to arrive at solutions to enlarge the scope of higher education for the benefit of the students. Karnataka is the front runner in many fields. Our state is well known all over the world for its many strengths. Availability of qualified manpower in the state is the major backbone for its growing strength. Our vision for Karnataka is to continue to empower students by imparting a quality education, enabling skill development opportunities, and facilitating mutual resources equally for one and all. By doing this, we believe that we are able to make a student a confident person and responsible for his family and a society as well. To make easy our vision, we had initiated in the year 2015 a number of initiatives and reforms in higher education. Jnana Sangama is a prominent initiative aimed at bringing a large-scale reforms in administering quality education and good content delivery using the power of information technology and communications and also audio and video technologies. Today, there are many challenges before the people who manage and run the higher education institutions. These institutions have to provide a quality education to students to make them competitive. Also, skills of the students have to be sharpened and upgraded so that they can be gainfully employed anywhere in the state and the country and the world. Technology is enabling the administration to leverage its potential for the benefit of the students in all aspects of learning. As you are all aware, that on December 28, 2015, the University Grants Commission had issued a circular to all the vice chancellors of the country requesting an online admission system for all the programs offered by the universities beginning year, academic year, June-July 2016. It is noteworthy to mention that Karnataka is ready with the online admission system at all its universities and colleges. Students seeking admission for higher education program can use online or offline admission system beginning a new academic year. Higher education is a very important and a developing country. Like India, it is encouraging to increase the human development. Higher education in India has experienced a phenomenal expansion since independence. India has produced scientists, engineers, technologists, doctors, teachers, and managers who are in great demand all over the world. Now, it is one of the top 10 countries in our industrial and technological capacity. Because of the significant contribution of manpower and tool provided by the higher education, especially technical education, India has already entered into the era of knowledge explosion. It has proved its tremendous potential by its performance in nuclear and space domains. In the coming few decades, will be heralded by spacecraft, satellites, internets, and other offshoots of scientific inquiries. Higher education provides an opportunity to the people to reflect on the critical, social, cultural, moral, economic, and spiritual issues facing humanity. India's higher education system in the world, third largest in terms of students, next to China and United States. Unlike China, however, India has the advantage of English being the primary language of higher education and research. The main governing body at the tertiary level is the University Grants Commission of India, which enforces the standards, advises the government, and helps to coordinate between the center and the state. The reforms being introduced in Karnataka, especially in the higher education, will have a far-reaching positive impact on the capacity. I hope and believe that reforms carried out in right earnest and with zeal would benefit all the stakeholders. I hope this Jnana Sangama conference will provide a right platform for all of you to discuss, deliberate, and exchange the ideas and the best practices for the benefit of the stakeholders of the higher education system. Before I conclude, the S.V. Rangnath, Vice-Chancellor, the Vice-Chairman of the Higher Education Council, has suggested and put forth a lot of issues before us. It is for us to deliberate on this issue. And the Sri Hari, the Deputy Chief Minister, is also here. And we all know Karnataka is spending almost 22,000 crores of rupees on education itself. In spite of so much money is being invested in the education, we are still starving for the funds for the higher education. So there is a necessity. I think almost all the states having the same problem of funding. And it is necessary that we should take up the issue with the chief ministers of all the states and ultimately to the prime minister, so that unless the funding increases, it is unable to reach our goal. And Srihari and myself, we were in London for a world conference on education. And I went to Manchester also, the university in Manchester University. And when I went there, Srihari, I tell you, there are 3-4 prime ministers of other countries who are also visiting the laboratories there. I spent almost 2 days there. When I talked to the vice chancellor there, she said the capital investment of the university in Manchester is more than, in terms of money, it is more than 40,000 crores. 40,000 crores. So that is the reason they are able to produce lot of Nobel laureates from London. Likewise, I have seen one university in Wisconsin, University in Chicago. There also, the investment is more than 30,000 crores. We can't even imagine it also. Unless the investment comes in a big scale for the higher education, we are not able to achieve this goal. Of course, as a technocrats, scientists, and vice chancellors, you can deliberate. Ultimately, we should take it up with the political bosses and to see that the funding is increased. Unless we achieve this, it is very difficult to reach our goal. Why I am mentioning all these things? Because Srihari is the deputy chief minister, and Telangana is one state, he is having no problem at all. They have almost all solved all the irrigation problems, and there is lot of money available to them for to invest in higher education. And like Andhra and Karnataka are like brother states. There is lot of exchange programs, it's also a fact that the many people from Telangana understand Kannada, and lot of people from Karnataka understand Telugu also. That is also, that exchange is also there, and reciprocal exchanges are also there. And if you can initiate this matter with the Prime Minister, that I think we will all come to your rescue and to take up the matter at the national level. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, Honorable Minister. As you suggested, that deliberation and discussion is required, and as you know that representatives from states are there, Rajasthan Education Commissioner, policymakers from Telangana and Andhra Pradesh and various states are there. So we will discuss on these issues, sir, with your guidance and support.